This video explains the histogram features for the SPC for Excel software package. Suppose you have some data on conversion and you'd like to do a histogram to see what the shape of the distribution looked like. So you start by entering your data into an Excel spreadsheet, as we've done here. We have 100 data points for percent conversion, and we want to make a histogram using that. So we start then by going to the SPC for Excel menu. We want to select our data to start with, so we'll use Select Cells to do that. And then we select Basic for Basic Histogram from the Histogram panel. And up comes our histogram input form. The data is the data that is in column A. It can be in multiple columns and can be in multiple rows. And we're going to enter a name for the chart. We're just going to call this Conversion. Now, this is all we really need to make a histogram, but there's some options we'll add this time around as well. So we're going to show the options here. And you have the option to add descriptive statistics. You have yes for all of them, or no for none of them, or you can select or change which ones you want. So you can see here we have mean, standard error, standard deviation, range, and the option here to check all or uncheck all in this case. And we're going to just cancel this. What we're going to do is we want to use all the descriptive statistics. So we select yes, hit OK, and we're going to skip the titles, rounding, and dates for now. And come over, and we're going to add some specifications. And suppose our lowest specification is 65%, and we don't need a nominal or an upper spect in this case. And you have some distribution options. You can add a normal distribution, or you can add a non-normal distribution. And there are 13 different non-normal distributions that you can add to the histogram. We're just going to select normal, and select OK, and come back and select OK, and then we have our completed histogram as shown here. Let's take a look at some of the other options that come with the histogram feature in the SPC for Excel software. We'll go back and select options from the SPC for Excel toolbar, select the chart we want to change options for, which is conversion, and it brings back up the original dialog box. So you always go back in and change any of the options that you have. For example, we can take off descriptive statistics if we want, but we will leave them on. You can also come in and change the rounding that's used in those descriptive statistics, if it rounds too much or rounds too little. You could also enter the starts of an end of data collection, and we'll just say maybe this was January 2014 through February 2014 is when we collected our data, and we select OK and hit OK again, and you can see now that we have our dates of data collection down in the lower left hand corner. Some other options going back will include changing the number of classes. You can go in and you can change the number of classes. There were about 10 on the chart. Maybe we want to double that. You can select 20, select OK, come back and OK again, and you can see now that we have increased the number of classes in the chart. So that's part of the options for the SPC for Excel histogram. Now we'll take a look at how easy it is to update the histogram chart. Essentially all you do is go back to your original data, and we're going to add some more data at the end. What we'll do is add some larger numbers so we can see that they're definitely picked up by the program and changed. So we'll add some numbers that are like 80, 82, 84, 85, 82. And then you simply go to Update Charts. Select the chart you want to update, conversion, select OK, and if you have dates in there, it'll come back to ask you if you want to change the dates, leave the dates the same, or delete the dates. I'll leave them the same for now. We select OK, and you'll see now that we have our new data added out here at the top of the histogram. So this is how easy it is to update an existing histogram using the SPC for Excel software package. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for taking the time to watch it. Thank you.